Space is big, like really big. Of the many probes, orbiters, and surveyors the people of Earth have sent into space to explore our universe, an uncomfortable number have been lost. Lost spacecraft make people crazy, engineers included. We spend millions of dollars to send these things to a very specific place, so how do we just lose them? What happens if we lose things in space? If they're millions of miles away and they're far too small to see with telescopes, what do? Usually, lost in this context means loss of contact. It doesn't always mean that we don't know where something is. Engineers and mathematicians calculate the trajectories of everything we send into space, but those calculations aren't perfect. Sorry, y'all. So if a spacecraft stops talking to us, at some point, it can drift away from our calculations, which brings us back to space is big. The losses range from the Soviet Zond 3, which sent pictures of the far side of the moon for the first time, but was lost on the way to Mars, to NASA's infamous Mars Climate Orbiter, which got lost because NASA's team mixed up metric and English units, and even a Japanese probe named Akatsuki, which was lost trying to orbit Venus. But then it was found again, and being found again is the sweetest in space. The verse is scary for little probes just trying to get where they're going. So when we send spacecraft to Mars, Pluto, or even just down to the International Space Station for milk, we give them lots of ways to tell us where they are. The Mars Science Laboratory that carried Curiosity to Mars had multiple antennas to communicate with Earth and other spacecraft already at Mars that could relay those signals back. The Curiosity rover itself also has multiple antennas to talk to spacecraft in Mars orbit as well as Earth directly through the Deep Space Network, which is awesome. Again, engineers work really hard and design spacecraft to make sure that if something does go wrong, they still won't lose it. To you and me, when we hear something is lost in space, we probably get a sense of dread, and not just because of the terrible 1998 film. It just seems too daunting a task to find something that's lost in space. But NASA's got skills, and there is nothing more hype than finding something you thought was lost forever. For example, Chandrayaan-1, an Indian Space Research Organization probe currently orbiting the moon, was just found by NASA's Jet Propulsion Laboratory. It had been missing since 2009. The ISRO lost contact with it, and they simply couldn't find it again, so they ended their mission. But then JPL shot a large amount of microwaves at the moon from Addition, California, and picked them up all the way over in West Virginia. They analyzed the bounce back and found old Chandy orbiting 200 kilometers above the moon. Boop, there it was. It once was lost, but now, well, actually, it's still lost because they can't communicate with it, I guess. That's not typical, though. These are computer systems. A big part of the problem is pinpointing their exact location. At that point, you just give it a call and hopefully it picks up. This happened in a less gloriously scientific way with a solar research sat called Stereo B. Part of a pair, Stereo A and B. The twins were programmed to fly around the sun and take 3D pictures of mass ejections and flares. Unfortunately, B was lost in 2014 when scientists tested its reset function, and it just never really came back. They knew its orbit, they knew where it would be, but they couldn't talk to it because sometimes the sun was in the way, and it wasn't responding to their hails. Fast forward 2 years, scientists were still tracking where it should be and kept sending messages its way, and eventually, they got lucky. In 2016, Stereo B came back online. There was enough charge in its batteries, or its antenna was pointed in the right direction. They got a ping back. These computer systems are designed to live in one of the harshest environments known to man. They can be the size of a small SUV like Curiosity or an oven-sized cube like Chandrayaan-1. But space is big and sometimes things get lost. If we're lucky and we keep sending signals, we hopefully built them smart enough to be found. There are so many stories of satellite rescue, maybe you should make a website to catalog them all. When you buy a domain name from domain.com, you're taking the first steps in creating an identity and vision for your brand. No domain extension will help you tell your story like a .com or .net domain name. Get 15% off domain.com's already affordable domain names and web hosting when you use the coupon code SEEKER at checkout. Do you have a science story you want us to look into and tell? Share your ideas with us over on Twitter at Seeker, and if you want a really incredible cow of a tale, check out this video about how vaccines came from a cow. Well, milkmaids. Just watch it. And subscribe for more stories on Seeker.